The year is 2020, later known as the year of the consumer, and the vast reaches of the internet are now in the hands of the people. An easily navigated internet allows users to quickly find whatever information or content they need. It seems a distant memory from 1990 when an Englishman, Tim Berners-Lee, created what is later called the World Wide Web. From the humble beginnings of the banner in 1994 through to the spectacular crash of the year 2000 came businesses and brands built on simple consumer truths allied with new technologies. The consumer had never had it so good. But with video on demand becoming the norm and the rise of user-generated content, they were facing more choice than ever before, more content than they could ever have imagined. However, the search-savvy audience of 2006 was ready for the extensive fragmenting of the internet that was taking place. The audience was empowered to store, search, and find their content whenever they needed it, and the power was in their hands. The following years saw a surge of development in search technology. Google and Amazon merged, bringing together the recommendation technique used on Amazon and the search tools of Google. Googlezone is created, and thanks to its sophisticated tagging techniques, the internet became no longer the blunt tool it once was. YouTube, MySpace, and hundreds of imitators were now flying, and in 2010, Google launched Google TV, allowing consumers to find and view TV content housed anywhere in the world. Consumers became the new media owners, and in 2012, Chris Kay, a former teacher from Bolton, was seen as a leading authority in TV dramas. His online blog was known as the place to find brilliant content, and he became the first consumer content millionaire due to his referrals. Google digitized every book that had ever been written and uploaded it into their systems for free instant access. And by 2015, the consumer was faced with over 30,000 different access points to view Little Britain. Traditional media sources struggled, and by the next year, The Times printed its very last paper issue. When Murdoch bought YouTube in 2017, the world's entire TV content was made available online and in every language. Yet it still accounted for less than 4% of the content available online. By 2020, the year of the consumer, an important milestone is reached when no one site records above 3% of total user traffic. The consumers are now finally in control, effectively managing and organizing their own content via thousands of access points. The role of the big media owner is now less relevant, and the consumer has finally become the broadcaster.